Well, welcome back to Most Haunted Live. We're reaching the climax now of our investigation. We're coming to you from the World War II living quarters for the RAF base at Clambeda. Now, it's said to be absolutely overrun with paranormal activity, and it's been a really busy night already. Yvette and Derek and the rest of the investigation team are set to hold another vigil at a new site on the base. But the twist is, they don't know where that is yet. But you, the audience at home, have decided. You've actually decided where they are going to go. But before we send them off, what we're going to do is we're going to find a member of the audience here to go with them and to confirm that the experiences are genuine. So earlier today, we chose someone at random from our studio audience tonight. And that person is... Carly Phillips. Right, Carly, if you can make your way towards the back, join Neil. And you can see Carly is now heading out to join the investigation team. She looks very, very excited about it. But the question is, where have you, the viewers at home, sent the team? Well, Julian has the answer.
Yes, now, well, the theory, David, is this. If a group of people use their intuitive or psychic judgment, the weight of numbers will focus the power. This is called psychic resonance. So over the last two nights, we've been asking you to look at a map on the site, on our Living TV site, and decide where that should be. Where is that zone? Where is that spot? So let's look at the map here. Thank you very much to everyone who got involved in this. And let's put the spot up, which is the most popular site. And there it is, just down there. You can see it there on the map. And I can tell you, just looking at my references, that is the projection room. So, Yvette and Derek, let's hand over to them right now. Hi, Yvette. Hi, Derek. Are you all right out there?
It's very, very windy.
It looks pretty stormy to me. Like, we've got where you've got to go, Yvette and Derek. You're off to the projection room. The projection room.
Okay, well, at least that's inside.
Okay.
That's brilliant. We'll make our way there now, okay?
Right, thanks, Yvette. Okay. So, Yvette, thank you. And David, back to you.
Thank you very much indeed, Julian. So, the projection room it is. Now, historians Richard Jones and Richard Felix, you've spent 3 days here. You've been looking around. What about the site that the audience at home have decided to send them? The projection room. Significant?
Yes, I suppose so. I mean, there's a lot of poltergeist activity in that room. And at the end of the day, the one thing that people are frightened of are poltergeists, more so than ghosts. They believe them to be evil spirits that throw things around, physically move people, pull them out of bed. They are frightening things. Personally, I think all it is a cry for help from a trapped soul that's actually there that wants release. I don't think they're trying to hurt people. I think they're just moving things to say, knock, knock, I'm here, can you please help me in some way?
Right.
So I don't think there is anything to be frightened of.
And actually, last night, that was the room that, do you remember, we left Stuart
in? There, yeah.
And Stuart is not a man who's easily frightened, but he didn't really enjoy being in there, did he?
He didn't at all.
He didn't like it. The temperature dropped, of course, while he was in there. And it is a place of activity, there's no doubt about it. People do not like to be in there. So anybody being in there, I wouldn't like to be in there on my own, even though I'm saying, you know, there's nothing to be frightened of. Don't forget, I'm frightened of ghosts.
All right. Well, we shall see. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Okay, let's go and rejoin Yvette, Derek and the rest of the team.
Okay, well, we're here inside the projection room. Thank goodness we're inside because it's absolutely blowing a storm out there. Now, this room is particularly small. And what we thought we'd do, I know, Kieran, you think it's quite a good idea.
Yeah.
We thought we'd actually set up a table, because what they used to do in here was they actually used to relax, play cards, sort of wait for their next sort of sortie that they'd fly out on. So we thought we would set up a table, which we have done here. We've put some cards on the table. We've also got, what's that, Kieran?
That's an actual relic from a crash site. So it's kind of left over from... a crashed plane in the local area.
We've also got an upturned glass on top of the table as well, haven't we?
Yeah.
Just explain what we're doing there.
Well, basically what you're looking at, we're not going to do table tipping. This is not the ideal table for table tipping anyway. The focus is on the glass and making the glass move. It's the same sort of principle as table tipping, in that we'll have collective energy, we'll be trying to communicate with the spirits and get the glass to move. Also, it could be group psychokinesis. That means we could be using group psychic energies to attempt to move the glass.
Okay, so the spirits could be in this room. This this is why we've set up this particular experiment to try and encourage any paranormal activity. Now, I know we have left somebody. Do you remember when we went back? We were actually in the air raid shelter quite early on in the programme, and we left a member of our team down there. We actually left Carl there, and he's been there all this time. So I don't know if, Carl, can you hear me?
Yes, you know, I can hear you loud and clear.
What's been happening down there?
I'm very disorientated. There's been a lot of sounds. I thought I could smell a very strong smell of like leather. It's been coming and going. I know I'm outside, but there's been some cold spots. They've been really freezing cold. It's not nice in here. It's really oppressive. I'm very disorientated at the moment.
Are you feeling all right?
I'm okay.
Are you all right to stay there for a while longer?
Yeah, I'll stay until something appears.
Okay, well, if something... I can hear you, so if anything happens, then shout out, okay?
Okay, I will do.
All right. Right, should we get in position? Do you want to start that?
Yeah.
Kath,
yeah.
Do you want to come in? And maybe Sally, do you want to be involved? Oh, Carly, come on in. Hi, Carly. You're all right. Do you want to stand and watch and Sally, do you want to come in?
Yeah, that's fine.
If you stand and watch Carly, is that all right? If you just stand here, that'd be great. Oh, if you go over there, that'd be great. We'll get in position.
Okay.
All right. Derek, are you actually feeling anything in this room?
At this moment in time, I'm not aware of a spirit person here, but that can change within moments, as you know, Ivy.
Okay, all right. So what do you think the best thing is to do right now?
Right. Okay. Well, what we can do, just spend a moment.
Okay.
And in quietude, and just, you know, send our loving thoughts out and ask very sincerely for the presence of an individual, whoever, that comes into this room in visitation.
Okay.
Yeah.
Would you like me to talk, Derek?
Yes, come on.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, maybe it's a good idea, actually,
yes,
if we put our
yes.
place our fingers
yeah.
on
let
that.
Let me move this so that
okay.
put that on the floor.
Okay.
Okay.
So if we just put our fingers very, very lightly on the glass.
Yeah.
And just touching there. Are you happy with everything, Kieran?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Is there anybody here in this room with us now? Are there any spirit people here in the room with us now? If there is, please could you give us a sign? Please could you do something in this room to let us know you're here? Try and talk to us. Please let us know if you're here. Please could you try and move the glass? The glass is moving.
Mm-hmm.
Can you
slightly,
feel it?
Yes.
It's vibrating.
Yeah.
Yes.
No one's pushing this glass, are they?
No.
If you wish to talk to us, please can you move the glass? Please move the glass. Please try harder. Please move the glass for us. Please move the glass. Please move the glass. Thank you very much. Please move the glass. Derek, can you ask some questions?
Okay. We're very happy for your presence, spirit friend. Please continue to do what you've just started. Give us the impressions, thank you.
Look at that, look
the impressions
at that, look at
that you
look
are
that.
Strong here. Yes. Okay. I take it that you're happy that we're here. We're not here in any other way to respect you. There's no disrespect. He's laughing at us. He's laughing at us.
Ask yes and no
yes.
questions and say yes to move the glass.
Okay.
And no to keep it still.
Did you lose your life in flight or in battle after leaving this space, spirit friend? Please, if you did, please move the glass. Did you not lose your life in these war conditions? Oh, you lived on after the war conditions. Thank you.
Take your finger off, Derek.
Yes.
Sally, take your finger off. Okay. Ask again, Derek.
Were you a leader at this base, dear friend?
How are you feeling, guys?
Great. Yeah, it's weird.
It's just me. It's
okay.
All right.
Were you here in command at this base?
Which way's yes?
No, movement is
just
yes.
Just movement is yes. Okay.
I'm going to ask you another very simple question. Were you here in 1940? Were you here in 1941? Were you here in 1942?
Oh, God, did you feel that? Yeah. Pull away.
Yeah.
Flipping heck. Oh, my God.
Did you stay here after 43?
Ask if he can see us.
Oh, I can hear a voice.
Can you?
Yes. Continue on, friend. Continue on.
Can you see?
He's laughing.
Can
he's
laughing. Ask if you can see us or hear us.
Yes, can you see us in your atmosphere?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Is he in the room with us now?
Are you in this room, in your spirit body at this moment, in this room with us?
It's turning,
yes.
It's swivelling on its...
I can hear them. It's laughing again. He's laughing.
Who do you think it is?
Okay.
Who do you think it is?
Okay. Who are you? Please, can you give me through either conversation or put it into my mind? He keeps on saying, bingo. Bingo? What does bingo mean? I can hear you say bingo. Bingo.
Is that your nickname?
Is that your nickname? Yes. Oh. Okay.
Did he used to stay in this room? Did he rest in this room?
Did you ever come and stay in this room? Sit in this room for any time or any reason?
Yes. Okay.
It's so strong.
I know.
It's a really, really strong push, isn't
yes.
it?
Does he want us to stay here or does he want us to...
Do you want us to stay here? Are you prepared to reveal more? Can you give us other obvious signs? Can you give us other obvious signs apart from the glass movement? Knock on the table, around the area of the room.
What?
What was that?
I heard a knocking.
You thought you heard a knocking?
Yeah.
Which direction?
Yeah.
Direction.
Like
on metal.
Do you want to turn around and just tell us what you heard?
Heard a knocking on metal coming from over there. Okay. Sounds like sort of metal.
Okay,
so that could be responding.
Could you try another knocking sound? Ask him, please.
Yes. Can you try another sound, please? Or anything that you wish to do would be very, very appreciative.
What about spinning the glass? Spin the glass.
Can you move the glass in different ways that you've achieved up to now, please, for us?
Okay. Can he touch one of us?
Yes. Can you come round the circle? And we'd be quite happy for you to touch one of all of us that are sitting in the circle, around the hairline, the face, the hands, the shoulders. Please attempt to do that.
Oh.
He's wanting to come to a vet.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Oh, it's so cold. It is so cold. Okay. I've just had a blast right across my legs and across my face.
Okay, he's chosen you then. Okay.
I can feel that.
Can we, please, can you give a little bit more of the indication of your presence around the vest?
Jesus.
Yes, okay.
Yeah.
Please go gentle.
He's all right across my legs.
Is he? He's
yeah,
okay.
I can feel it.
Yes, I've done very cold, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, he is attempting to do it, but he's a lovely spirit. He's a good spirit man.
Can you smell smoke?
Yes.
Can you smell smoke?
I can't smell anything. I'm just so... Mm. I'm freezing.
Okay. Okay.
The temperature has gone down by about 2 degrees.
His atmosphere is round about now. Okay. Can you help us a little bit more? I'm very open as a channel. Please speak. Please. Any audibles, any sounds? Okay, you're still feeling it across your legs?
No, I'm feeling emotional now.
Okay.
I just feel very, you know, just like
yes.
You want to cry, but I'm not going to.
Okay. This one is only in visitation, I feel. He's in visitation. He's not grounded the soul. And I feel very, very authoritative with him. Okay. Sam, can you help me with this as well? In helping us with the communication of this good spirit man? Bless you.
Oh, God, I'm freezing. Okay. I'm so cold. Oh, it's like a whirlwind. It's like it's really rushing.
Vivi, the spirit person that is with you, around you, is a very authoritative figure.
Mm.
And Sam's just said to me to mention this.
Yeah.
He said, you have bingo with you. You have bingo. And I said, we have bingo. He said, yes, you have bingo brown here. So this person is calling himself Bingo Brown.
Okay.
Bingo Brown. And he's looking round this area. It's like as if he's been in and around the whole of this site.
Can you go to somebody else to let them feel
him? Can you move, please? Now that I know his name. Can you move, please, Bingo? I hope you don't mind me calling you Bingo. Away from a vet's oil
field.
Did
you feel that?
Yes.
Whoa.
I felt it across here
Flipping
as well.
Egg.
Yes.
Where did you feel
right
it?
Right across here.
Yeah. Can you choose, please, another within this circle to come close to our auric fields? And we will know that you are close by us. Individually.
Ask him to move the glass who he would like to
please,
go to
Bingo,
next.
Bingo, can you move the glass, please, to maybe the person you would like now to move to?
No.
Thank you, Bingo. Please, in a nice, gentle approach.
I can feel it coming across the table.
I can feel it on my legs.
Yes. Ooh. Just give the indication that you are close to Sally, please, without any harm. I know you wouldn't harm her. You're a gentleman. He's a very authoritative man, but I feel a good man, a good soul, a good spirit man, this.
Are you feeling anything?
I can just feel cold right up my legs.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh, God,
I
can feel it.
Oh,
it's
God.
Chosen the ladies.
Can you feel anything, Kath?
Yeah.
Whoa!
That's okay.
It's just me.
It's just me.
Here.
It's all right.
My hands are icy cold.
Can you feel
whoa.
How cold
it's
yeah.
I feel it across you.
I'm just going to touch
yes.
Tyson's hands.
Mine's warm, that's okay, but it's getting cooled.
Yeah, but certainly Sally, Kath, and Yvette. Very cold hands.
Now.
Very cold hands.
I'm all right now.
I feel heat from yours.
You're all right.
So yeah, I'm fine.
He's with me.
Yes.
Can he touch me?
Can you please, Bingo? I hope you don't mind me calling you that. Bingo, can you please? Oh God, I just heard him say something.
What? What?
He said, "Don't you call me Bingo." What's that? He's foreign. It's not English. Don't you go... Go on, Sam, say that again. What did he say? I missed it. Go on. I've got to call him Air what? Air Vice Marshal. Air Vice Marshal. I've got to call him. He's here in this room.
Oh. Okay.
Can you... Are you going back to Sally?
No.
Where are you going? Can you do something else, please? Air Vice Marshal? Look at this. Thank you. Thank you. Bless.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
Good. Good man.
Oh, my God.
Take your fingers off.
Take fingers off.
Okay, well, well, well. Bless. Thank you. You okay?
Okay, yeah, I'm fine. Ooh,
sure.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, he's a good soul, Libby.
Yeah. Okay, we've got to go to a break now. No, sorry, that's just really shaking me up. Yep. We're going to come back to this, okay? Please join us after a break. Oh. Well, I am completely freaked out by what's just happened here. The glass was spinning round and round. How did everybody else feel? How did you feel, Sally?
I've just gone really cold and my hands are shaking.
Yeah. What about you, Kat?
It's horrible.
I thought it was great. Really, really exciting.
Yeah. What about you, Derek?
I did that spirits man bingo. Dunno was proud.
Okay.
He tried very hard.
Do you want to very quickly close it down?
Yes, please.
Just very quickly.
Yes.
So we have to do it really quickly.
Yes. My good spirit friend, bingo. We thank you for your efforts, and we would now like to leave you and for you to leave us, and we will go on further into the investigation. And we wish you well. Thank you for your efforts.
Thank you. Thank you. I just want to ask our audience member as well, very quickly, what did you think, too, what had happened there?
It was the way it was spinning around. It was, didn't feel frightened, but I felt really calm, like he was, like, playing and kind of... Freaky. kind of weird to ever see something like
Okay, Kieran, very quickly.
Temperature differences that people were getting was objectively picked up by my meter. There are possibility of a couple of drafts, but we all saw the glass move.
Okay, and Carl, can you still hear me? Because, Carl, you're in the air raid shelter.
Yes, I can hear you.
Are you all right?
Absolutely fantastic. It's been one hell of an experience down here. I know I'm not on my own. I can't explain why I think that, but I feel very comfortable. I've heard so many things. I've seen a lot of light anomalies, and I'm still hearing things now, which is quite surprising.
What, like, sort of things are you hearing?
I'm hearing creaking, like somebody sitting in a leather chair, or certainly footsteps. I sat down earlier and I felt two people were kind of next to me, like I was sitting on a bus. But it's very comfortable. It's phenomenal, really. I'm invigorated. I'm not frightened, which
is great.
Yeah, which is great.
Unlike us here.
How's it going that end?
Oh God, the glass was spinning round. It's unbelievable. So there you go, David. I don't know what you and the rest of the team in the studio think to what's just happened here. I mean, I'm speechless. I'm still shaking. I really can't believe it.
And I have to say, I have never, ever, ever seen anything quite like that. Historians, what about this name, Bingo Brown, Air Vice Marshal?
Well, it's fascinating, actually, because, as we mentioned earlier, Air Vice Marshal Bingo Brown, he was the South African Air Vice Marshal who sent 26 of his 29 squadrons here to train for Operation Overlord, which was to begin with D-Day. So.
And Derek said he was foreign. Was he foreign?
He was South African, and his nickname was Bingo Brown.
Oh. Richard Felix, what do you make of that? Oh,
well, I mean, it's the closest thing you're probably going to get to actually getting in touch with the spirits. I'm telling you, that happens a lot with us now, and it's wonderful.
Right, hang on. Right, okay. Louis Saba.
Well, it's very impressive.
Talk your way out of that one.
Well, I mean, as I said, it's very impressive. Parapsychologists have been looking at this kind of thing for over 100 years now. And, you know, there's some very good evidence which shows that unconscious muscular movements, and I'm not saying people are actually pushing it on purpose, but unconsciously are pushing very, very minute forces, muscular movements, which is translated into quite large movements. And there is some very, very good research.
Louis, have you just seen
what I saw?
I know
it's not impressing you. I know. Well, there is good research, so...
But are you seriously telling me that you honestly believe those people moved it round on their own?
I'm not saying that they're pushing it on purpose, okay? I'm saying what they're doing is they're unconscious movements, so unconsciously.
Okay.
And I'm not also saying that the information they're getting isn't coming perhaps paranormally. I'm not saying that's not possible. What I'm saying is that unconscious movements are causing the glass to move.
David Wells.
Well, I think that it's not just the movement of the glass. Have you noticed that Kieran was saying lift your finger? He was telling people independently to lift the finger, so it wasn't one particular person, because someone could say, like, one of them's doing this.
Yes. And Derek took his fingers off, didn't he?
Everybody did. Everybody in sequence and random took their fingers off. What I think was really interesting was, if you watch these guys, if you watch Yvette, Sally, and even Carl, what these guys have been doing for 3 years, are this twice, three times a week sometimes, their awareness is heightening, so they are all becoming channels. Yvette's emotions are a clear sign that spirit's there, because you feel the tenderness. That they're all doing it. That's what's interesting for me.
And what do you make of what Louis is saying?
The unconscious movement. I think that maybe we do move it. I'll give him that. But I think it's spirit channels via through our bodies. It's the same principle as dowsing. The same perhaps as any kind of healing where it comes through. However, it's subconscious, but because it comes from spirit, and spirit's making a move.
Well, I have to say, I think it's absolutely astounding. Louis, what would you convince you? You know, to see a glass run around the table is quite impressive.
Certainly, I didn't say it isn't impressive. It is very impressive. I'm more interested in the information we're getting through and whether we can say, is it paranormally acquired?
Okay.
So that for me is more interesting than the actual glass moving.
I have to jump in because so much is happening here. We have to go now to our 1940s room because something is going on there. Let's go and join them now. Hello there. You're involved in our experiment tonight, aren't you?
Yes.
Tell me what's happened to you tonight?
Well, just before we heard the bottles rattle in the cellar, I actually saw a shadowy figure go through into the cellar. But Andy, who was facing the same way and looking in the same direction, didn't see that at all.
No, didn't at all.
Okay, and why do you not think that was just someone's shadow, someone who's in that room?
It wasn't a shadow. It was definitely someone going through the door.
What did they look like?
I've been looking at it. It was a man, but I couldn't see anything more distinguishable than that.
Could you see anything that he was wearing? Was it modern day? Was it old day?
I couldn't see, no. Because it's very dark over in that corner.
Of course. And have you been experienced any of this sort of phenomena before?
Not before tonight, no. I've never experienced anything.
Thank you very much indeed. It's been quite an extraordinary night. There is so much more to come. We're going to bring you more from that time slip experiment. We're going to bring you all sorts of other things. We're also going to reveal the secret chamber as well. And the investigation continues. You can't afford to go anywhere. See you in a few minutes. Welcome back. I'm sure you're sitting on the edge of your seat. It's rapidly approaching the time to test the success of our time slip experiment. Now, as well as listening to the experiences, as we have done, of those participants, what we want to do is we intend to see what kind of psychic presence has been created by performing a table tipping experiment. Now, that's apparently when a group of people harness the psychic energy in a room and then they use it to try to move a table. And we've chosen this experiment at this room because it's already been host to a number of successful table tips. And we can see that in this video, which was made by an established ghost group. So let's have a look at that now. As you can see, these people are around that table. Look, that table is moving anti-clockwise, okay? And they're moving with the table, and they're focusing their psychic energy, making that table move. And as you see, the table collapses. So, it seems that the room plays host to a very mischievous spirit indeed. These tend to be the ones that respond most effectively to a table tip. Louis and David, what are your thoughts on this particular experiment on table tipping? David?
Well, having done table tipping quite a few times, it's just absolutely phenomenal. It's fantastic. I absolutely love it. You should feel, sometimes you feel the presence of something right through your own fingertips. The table just vibrates, and other times it literally goes off to the other side of the room.
Do you know, fantastic. I've seen it actually. I went to see another a psychic medium who is on Living TV, and I was amazed by what I saw. Mm. Louis?
Well, obviously there are some theorists who believe it's very similar to the glass moving, so I don't want to say unconscious muscular movements, but again, yes, you have enough people around a table, and there is some good research to show that. However, you know, as a parapsychologist, I'm not opposed to the idea that it's some kind of psychokinesis going on, so perhaps some people are using their paranormal abilities to somehow move the table.
So
it might work, yeah.
Thanks. Okay, well, Yvette and Derek are now over there, they're set up, so let's go straight over and see what happens.
Okay, we're here, we're doing table tipping, we've started, and there's Carl, there's Sally, there's myself and Derek, and there's the rest of the team here. Even as we're actually here in the officer's mess, and even as I'm talking, I'm getting a draft around my legs. This table has been specifically made. It has casters at the bottom so the table can move. There is a bell at the top. Kieran, explain a little bit more about what we're going to do.
Table tipping, again, is another form of communication with spirit. Like Louis said, it could be group PK that possibly might happen. This is a unique table because of the bell that we've got there. It means, as well as you reporting that the table might be moving, we can hear the bell. So everybody at home, people in the studio audience would be able to actually hear the table moving, as it were.
Okay, all right. So the energy's going around the circle. We've already started. The energy's going round from left to right. It's going down my left arm. It's going to the person on my left. Get the energy flowing around the table. Get the energy going. I'm feeling a swirling of cold air around my legs. Anybody else feel that?
I can feel a chill into my left side,
yeah.
Across the legs.
Okay, do you feel there's anyone here, Derek?
I feel we are being watched.
Okay.
And we're being listened to, Yvette.
Okay. Do you want to ask out, Derek?
Yes, do you mind?
No, go.
Okay. For the spirit person or spirit persons that's in attendance here with us, within this circle, around the table, would we encourage you to help us understand and to know more that you are actually here in this atmosphere. We do it with respect, not disrespect. Whatever you wish to do, where the table is concerned, please go ahead and do it with your spiritual power.
Move your hands back, fingers to the edge. Slightly touching, right at the edge, Derek.
Yes, sorry.
That's it, okay. Is there anybody here in this room with us now? Is there any spirit person here now in this room that would like to talk to us? We've been here all day. There's a bang at the back.
Yes.
I thought it actually came from that direction.
Okay.
So.
Please, can you give us a sign if there's a spirit person here in the room with us? If you'd like to talk to us, try and communicate with us, so we can get to know you a little better, please try and move this table as a sign of yes. If you'd like to talk to us, please move this table. Please try and use our collective energy. We're here. We don't mean you any harm. Use our collective energy and try and move this table. Please. Please come forward. Come into the light and try and talk to us. We know you're here. We can feel you. Please try and push this table as a sign of yes.
That's through there. I'm going to go through there.
Okay.
Please, there.
Please move this table as a sign of yes. Whoa. Whoa. Did you feel that?
Yes.
Yeah, came towards you.
Okay. Please try harder. Please move this table if you can. We need a more positive sign. If you're here, it's turning. It's turning. Please, please, please give us a sign. Please try a little harder. That's not hard enough. Please, I urge you. Please, can you move the table some more? Please, if you'd like to talk to us, please push the table harder. Please come forward. Use our energies now. Please push the table.
Okay.
Please push the table some more. Thank you. You're here in the room with us now. Okay. You're here in the room with us now. Okay. Are you male? Are you a male? Are you a male spirit? You are?
Yes.
Can you see us here in this room? Can you see us? Can you hear my voice? Derek, can you ask some questions?
Okay. Are you a person that has worked here? Whoa. Yes. Did you leave your physical body? Naturally? Push the table if this is yes. Okay. Did you lose your life in a way? Did you come down in a plane? Are you the person that linked with us earlier on? Are you an officer? Yes.
Okay.
Did you lose your life in wartime conditions?
It's going to go off the edge of the... Do you want to move it? Should we push it back up, lift it and push it back this way? Stay with us. Ask him to stay with us, Derek.
Stay with us, please. Stay with us.
Straight, wait.
It's moving already.
Isn't it?
Mm. Mm. Okay.
Okay.
So he died naturally?
Yes.
In wartime conditions.
It was war conditions, he said, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Sorry, forgive me.
I was confused, old.
Yeah. When you left your physical body, were you old? Were you young? Oh, yeah.
Oh. Oh. Wow, wow, wow.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah,
what? Less than 30, less than 20.
Okay.
And then narrow
it down. Were you less than 30 years of age? Were you older than 30? Were you 31?
Oh.
31 years of age. Were you 31 years of age when you left your life? Yes, I know, is it?
Ask him if it's him that watches the people dancing here.
Are you the spirit person that watches in attendance when the people dance here, when they're enjoying themselves? Did that move?
No. No, it didn't.
I felt like it juddered a bit.
Ooh.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
He didn't die in a plane.
Ask.
He didn't die in a plane.
He said that, didn't he? Mm.
Okay.
Go on, Carl, what did you say? Ask him.
I was going to say, being a bit... Why don't you girls have a try if he's a serviceman?
Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Were you married when you died? Were you a married man?
He was. Yeah. Oh, 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 oh.
Oh!
He seems to be happy with that.
Okay. Did you have children? Did you have two children? Did you have one child? Did you have three children?
Oh.
Three.
Yeah.
Is your wife with you now in spirit?
Yes. Oh, exactly she is.
Oh.
Whoa, hey. Thank you. Oh, you seem to be happy with that, that your wife's with you.
Oh, I'm getting dizzy.
Wow, wow.
She stopped.
Yeah.
Too much people to her hands up.
Yes.
Okay.
Just keep her hands up.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, he's gone again. Keep it up. Wow.
Can you raise the table for us off the floor if you can hear my voice? Can you try and raise this table? Please? Can you try and lift the table off the floor? Please try and lift the table off the floor for us.
Well done.
Thank you.
This is good.
Please try and lift the table. Can you lift it? Can you try and lift it for us? Please?
I'm getting dizzy with it.
I am.
He's loving this.
Oh, God.
My
Please
gosh.
Keep going.
Just,
Okay.
Wow.
Okay. Are you happy that we're here?
Oh. Wow. Okay.
Okay. I'm really dizzy. Do you want to ask a question, Sally?
Yeah.
Oh. Ask if you're watching the ladies dance.
Do you watch the ladies dance?
Oh.
Okay. Do you like the ladies?
No.
Or are you so in love with your wife that you don't have to look at ladies? Silly question. Okay.
Do you miss the dancing?
Do you miss to dance? Do you miss the dancing with you and your lovely lady wife? Did you used to dance a lot here in this room?
Gosh.
You did?
Whoa. Good on you.
Keep it up,
sir.
Oh! Ow!
Right,
I'm fine,
please.
I'm fine.
You okay?
Yeah. Just bash me in the hip. Okay. Oh. No, that's great.
Whoa.
Okay.
Oh, it's burnt.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Look at this.
Okay. I don't know, David, what you're making of this. I really have no idea what you guys are thinking in the studio, but we're not pushing this.
No.
We're not pushing it. Take your hands off, Sally. As soon as you take your hands off,
the energy
stops. As soon as you put it back on, it moves.
Yes.
Okay.
Super.
The thing is, when you push something, you usually can feel if you were pushing it towards me, I could feel it.
Exactly.
Yes.
If Derek was pushing it, I could feel
that. That's right.
The energy seems to be coming right from the centre.
When you push, the tablecloth goes anywhere.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. Are you still here with us in the room? Have you left or are you still here? You're still here. Okay.
Wow. This is great.
Okay. Will we find anything in this chamber? Will we find anything in the chamber outside? Will we find anything in the chamber outside?
Wow.
In the chamber outside? I've got one finger on here.
You're right, I'll stop.
Yeah. Will we find anything in the chamber? You're saying we are?
Wow.
Okay.
Keep it up, sir.
I'm not. I've got one finger on this. Derek, put one finger on it.
Keep
one finger on.
Okay.
Please keep moving this table. Please keep moving this table. Thank you very much. Are you laughing at us? Are you enjoying this? You're not enjoying it. Do you want us to go now? Do you want us to leave you? Would you like us to leave you now?
Yeah.
Okay. I can't quite believe this. Join us after the break. This is absolutely amazing. I can't believe it. It's madness. Join us after the break. Oh, my God. Amazing. Wow. We'll go right across the ground. If it's Ian... If you can hear my voice, please can you push this table right across the floor? Geoffrey, if it's Geoffrey, please can you push this table across the floor? I'm trying to think of some more names.
Please, Sam, is that the one earlier tonight? Go on, say it again.
Bingo? Is it Bingo? No.
Is it MacPherson?
Oh, gosh.
It is MacPherson.
It's MacPherson. Oh, my God.
Oh, my.
Okay, MacPherson. MacPherson, we're going to stop now.
Close it down.
We're going to close this down. MacPherson, thank you. Yes, please, please stop spinning the table. Stop spinning the table, please.
Take your hands off for a second.
Okay, all right. Do you want to close it? Thank you so much. Close it down there.
Okay. MacPherson, it has been absolutely wonderful. Thank you for putting this beautiful spiritual effort into. We're very proud of you, and thank you for being in attendance, but we now would like to leave and let you get on with other things. Maybe you can go back over into the light. It's been wonderful. Thank you. Bless you.
Thank you. Thank you. I can't quite believe it.
Oh, my God.
That was amazing. That was amazing. What did you think?
I don't know.
What can you think? We've just been in a table that's been spinning around so fast I can keep up with it at one point.
I know. Yeah. Kieran, what do you think?
I think it's amazing. I think Louis and I both know of possible explanations for this, and Louis may comment on it. But the interesting thing about this is the tablecloth. And like you say, if you try and push it, then you can see the tablecloth moving. Watching back the tape, maybe later on after the show, can see if that was actually occurring. But it's great.
The only way you can push it is actually if you have your thumbs here and you push like that. And not one of us had our thumbs here. We had them on the top. Yeah. And if you do push, look what happens to the... I can't push that. There's nothing that... I can't push that table. And also, that did not ring.
No.
That's weird. Mm-hmm. What do you make of it back at the studio? What do you make of that?
thank you very much indeed, Yvette. Louis, what do you make of that?
Well, it certainly is very impressive. I mean, as Kieran said, there is good research, though, showing that people do... unconscious muscular movement can produce this kind of phenomena. So
you just heard Carl saying the table was moving so fast he couldn't keep up with it.
Sure.
That's some unconscious movement.
Well, I mean, definitely it doesn't need all of the people to be touching it at all the time. So obviously if you take your hand off, then it does stop. So it does suggest you need hands on the table for the phenomena to be produced.
David Wells.
I agree with what Louis is saying, you need the hands on the table, because the whole point, Louis, is that the energy, spiritual energy, comes through our physical bodies. So he's not there doing this on the table, woo, look at me. He's coming through us as channels, and he's moving the table via our channels.
Okay, so what are you saying to Louis here?
I'll reserve judgment on that.
Okay, but you're convinced that worked?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, thank you. Let's go and see what our historians made of that. 31, married, name MacPherson, make any sense?
The name MacPherson does make sense. We mentioned earlier Bingo Brown sending 26 of the 29 squadron.
And Bingo Brown was the man who moved the glass.
Allegedly moved the glass earlier on, yeah. And when he was planning for Operation Overlord to start with D-Day at Bentley Priory and Stanmore, his staff of six who were under him included Wing Commander MacPherson and from earlier on Wing Commander Hurst.
Oh my goodness.
Louis and Matthew are completely and utterly beaten on this. There is no possibility that Matthew Smith, yeah. It may be interesting to both of them, but I promise you that that is definitely paranormal. There's no other explanation for it. They're beaten hands down, literally.
Thank you very much. What do our audience think? Do they agree?
Yes.
No, did you agree or not agree? Do you agree? Interesting. Julian, what are people saying at home?
Well, the reaction has been incredible to the table tipping and indeed the vigil earlier on. We've had 24,000 web and SMS text sightings tonight, by the way, 13,000 competition entries, 2,500 people tonight have participated in the EVP. Now, is this MacPherson? This is some psychic art and that's come through on the fax. So I just thought I'd show you that one. Came through at 9:30, interestingly, before we were talking about that. On table tipping, Matt in Liverpool was looking on the webcam 3, whilst that was going on, and he said he could see a man in the corner of the room. He says he's looked like he's saluting the team as it was going on. And the webcam froze for lots of people when the table started moving, including Michelle and Rob in Worcester and Susan in Burnley. And on webcam 4, this is the thermal imaging camera we've been running all evening. Lots of people looking at this, believe me. Hundreds of viewers have seen blue figures sitting and mingling around the dance floor with the dancers, and again since we've been having the table tipping. And thank you to those who've been in touch this evening. And just to mention webcam one, which is the air raid shelter, because we've been talking about that tonight. Joel from Manchester has just seen an orb in the top right-hand side of the screen in the air raid shelter. Mark Seymour from Southampton, Sharon from Stoke and Margaret from Perth have all seen orbs around Carl this evening, by the way. And Julie Durham from Doncaster says that about 20 minutes or so ago, there was a man with Carl who looked like was wearing a large overcoat and was standing at the back of the shelter. So thank you for all your comments tonight and a record response. That's absolutely brilliant. David, back to you.
Thank you very much indeed, Julian. Well, the world's largest live ghost hunt continues after this break. We'll see you in a few minutes' time. Welcome back to this, the final part of the final night of Most Haunted Live from North West Wales. Right, now we are now getting the green light from our health and safety officer that the excavation of the chamber has now reached a point where we can see it. So Yvette and Derek are at the chamber now. Guys, what is going on?
Okay, we're here actually inside the chamber. The builders have been working all day and taken out a lot of rocks and rubble. And we're here and you can actually see... Well, there are four walls. You can see the bricks here, which is absolutely amazing that we found it. What it was used for, I have no idea. So, Derek, what do you think this was used for? And do you think this was the whole of the chamber?
No, I don't. I feel, like we were saying only the other day,
yeah.
When we were doing the walk round, I did say that I saw an oblong chamber yeah. rather than square. But I believe that there's more to this. I believe it goes into like a T. And this is the beginning here. It goes off somewhere, but I can't make out. I feel it's, you know, going in this direction.
Right.
I feel this is the beginning of the chamber. It's not this solely four brick
just
walls.
Just this bit here. And are you picking any residual energy up here?
I'm not picking up anything of what we call negativity to link with this chamber.
Yeah.
I feel this chamber, and it's going off the feelings, the psychic feelings. It was a holding of something, items, for a period of time. I don't feel it was used as, you know, a person, a burial or anything like that. But I feel more, as we're standing here now, I feel as if it was a holding den for some reason, a holding. Now, what was it holding? What seems to be coming through to me here now is if we had some kind of storage, but the storage of something that was very, very important. Very important indeed, and I feel it was kept. How can I put it? It most certainly would have been under close watch by maybe guards or what have you, but something secretive,
almost hidden.
Yes,
yeah, so you're high, right.
There was very few people that knew of the contents of what was here. That's what I feel.
What do you think the contents were?
At this moment, I'm not getting that. I keep on asking about this. I'm even asking, you know, can something come from the residual? I feel that the head, and I use the word because I don't know the true wording of a person that could, a commandant, what have you, of this base here, was one of the few people that knew the contents in here.
Really?
I really do. And I feel... Oh, Divi, I've got something. Oh, bless. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Now I get so excited. Right. There was a very, very important man. Thank you, Sam. And Sam talked about his name before. And, yes, go on. Brown. He came here. He came here and what? Yes. Okay. He came here, he flew here, and he was the one who instructed the other officers to... What? Wow! The training officers for the pilots who came here from all over to train for the great battle.
Mm-hmm.
And the content of papers and what have you, of the plan. And the vice, yes, Thank you. Yes. Bingo! Bingo Brown ordered the officers to hold the paperwork and the important things for the biggest battle in the world.
Well, that is just perfect timing.
Yes. Yes.
Perfect timing. I hope that's okay in the studio. Can we come back? Because it's absolutely, the weather is absolutely awful. But I hope that's enough information to go on, because that for me was brilliant. So hopefully that's what we know the chamber was used for.
And is it just coincidence that the weather has closed in just at that moment? We shall find out. Historians Richard Jones and Richard Felix, tell me, this chamber, what was it used for, do you think?
We can rule out what we thought initially, the rumours. We said it was a blast chamber, simply because, of course, this was the living quarters, and they most certainly wouldn't have had a blast chamber for launching aircraft and missiles on the living quarters.
Interesting, because people have been postulating it was a blast chamber, so yeah. You're saying no, it couldn't be.
I think we could rule that out, because it's too close to the living quarters.
All right, Richard?
He's mentioned this chap, Bingo Brown, and Overlord. Of course, that was D-Day, June 6th, 1944. I suppose there is a possibility that it could have been some form of secure chamber underground, because he's mentioning papers, documents. I don't know. It's possible, but I would have been surprised if they'd have dug a hole in the ground to store papers, but I'm not so sure. But
Aren't you surprised that the audience at home actually chose a spot that we excavated and we found a chamber?
Yes, that is very, very good. Yeah. The power of thought, isn't it, of people all together, coming together all over the country and coming up with that. It's good.
Lovely. Like Thank it. You very much for the moment. Okay. Well, Louis, what do you make of that? You know, the fact is that people at home used their thought processes. They found that where they wanted us to dig, we dug, we found a chamber, there is the chamber, you saw the brick walls.
Sure, I mean, it's very interesting, and as a parapsychologist, I'm not opposed to the idea that people can somehow psychically gain information from remote locations. I mean, I do research which looks at telepathy, so you know, I'm not opposed to that idea. However, I believe it was 73% got that right, so obviously there's a significant proportion that didn't get it right, and we don't know how many other hidden chambers there might be on the site. And I remember Dr. Pringle on the first show said that there were a number of
Jamie Pringle, who did the radar survey,
said there were a number of possible sightings. So, you know, perhaps other people got the other sites, you know.
Maybe.
So,
David Wells, would you agree with that?
Well, 73% got it right, which is, significant-ish. I think it's outstanding. I think that's a fantastic figure. I think you're underrating them.
Louis?
I agree. So if the data is exactly the right spot, I mean, I'd like to have a look at the actual data. But yes, I mean, from from what we're being shown, it does look very good.
Lovely, Louis. We'll give you that data. Okay. Thank you. Julian.
Well, David, I think Stuart McMillan, he thinks it is a chamber. Here we have a fax from him, and he says the chamber may be a battle control room found on most airfields. And there he's got a drawing of what they would have looked like. So, Stuart, thank you very much for that. And can I just say the competition, the answer, because there are thousands of entries for this, extraordinary, to come to the next most haunted at Halloween. And the winners are Lisa Marie Gerard, Anne Theresa McGowan, Jeff Lewis Hallett, Elizabeth Graves and Sarah Wyatt. You've got Derby, which is the right answer. Where were we last time on Most Haunted Live? Congratulations. We'll see you in 6 weeks' time. David, back to you.
Well, thank you very much indeed, Julian. It has been an extraordinary night. I don't think anyone could have expected quite what happened tonight, but it gives me enormous pleasure to say, ladies and gentlemen, please will you welcome them back. It's Yvette Fielding, Derek Acorin, Kieran O'Keefe. Well, I have to say, it's been an unbelievable night. How's it been for you, Yvette?
I'm speechless. I'm absolutely speechless. You couldn't have wished for anything better. I'm absolutely ecstatic. We've had a glass going round and round and round, and the table, it hit me in the hip. It was unbelievable, wasn't it? I'm so excited.
Yeah. Derek?
Just exceptionally excellent. Thank you, spirit people. they responded to everything our asking. even more, it went over the top. It was fantastic, wasn't it?
Great.
Yeah. Do you know, one thing that I do want to pick up on tonight, you know, you came up with so many names tonight, Hyde, Page, Hurst, McPherson, and this chap, Bingo Brown, okay? Bingo Brown, this was the chap who moved the glass.
Yes.
Yeah, you remember? Do you know, what the historians were telling me just a while ago was that Bingo Brown, all those men worked under Bingo Brown, so they were all accurate men.
No. That's brilliant.
And also, in terms of the officer's mess and that table tilting, of course, that was McPherson again.
Yes.
So we again saw the same person coming back. How does that make you feel, Yvette?
I can't believe it. We've done so many different haunted locations. We've been around the country, we've gone to Europe, and I have to say, I can't believe how... It was just unbelievable what happened. The movement, people feeling things, the cold breezes, it was like a whirlwind around me and Kath around the table. I've never felt things like that before.
Let me ask you, Kieran, though, about all of these things. The table tilting, the glass, everything. What did you make of that? Take that for me and speak through that. But what did you make of those two particular experiments?
Of the movement and of those objects. Well, I think I've commented before on this sort of thing. Parapsychologists are aware of normal explanations for these particular things occurring. The great thing about the table turning, though, was the way we set up with the tablecloth so that you could see instantly if anybody was pushing it, and that's why it'd be great to look back at the footage and see if that happened. And I was examining it very closely, and for me, I don't think that occurred.
Well,
I think it was quite impressive.
Where we were sitting, I was talking to David earlier on, as far as we're aware, that wasn't the case, David, is it true?
Absolutely not. It was one of the first things that we picked. In fact, Sally was the first one to pick up on it, that the cloth was, you know, wasn't rushing up, and yeah, it looked great. It was fantastic.
Now, Louis, interestingly, Derek, says that the table moving and indeed the glass moving is involuntary muscular movements. This is what he said. He said, you did it.
I did it.
Well, no, all of you did it.
Oh, right.
No, he's not saying
okay.
that.
Okay, no. Well, yes, he's open to his opinion. I was there with Yvette, Kieran, and everyone else, and we know for a fact, okay, we're checking on each other whilst we've got our hands on that table, and no one but other than a spirit person who was in attendance was moving that table
responsibly. What about when all four of us actually had one finger?
Yes, that was incredibly impressive.
On the table.
Yes,
what
and
do you,
he,
what
he continued
that,
on.
Well, it certainly is very impressive, and I'd like to definitely go back and have a look at that videotape and analyse it.
I think what he's saying also... he's saying it's involuntary as well. He's saying that's what he's saying. So he's saying it's not any sort of conscious movement, and I think we're all very clear that that didn't happen. But as far back as 1852, Faraday was looking into these sort of things. Parapsychologists are still studying it even now, and there's still an open book.
What I can tell you tonight, I was on the edge of my chair watching that glass. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. I know our audience here were absolutely gripped. They were so quiet throughout the whole of that, the glass moving and the table. Let me ask you, audience, are you impressed by what you've seen? Yes or no? You see, I think it was a very, very compelling argument, Kieran. It seemed incredibly compelling.
Yeah, well, I think it was compelling. For me, the most impressive stuff that happened this weekend was actually the footsteps. I know we're focusing on the table turning and the actual glass, but for me, as an objective parapsychologist, part of the team has always been the objective one and trying to create balance, it's the footsteps. It's those recording of... by equipment, so it's not any sort of subjective experience by somebody. We've got an objective measure on these equipment, and that was fantastic.
So a good result, that.
Very, very good result.
And what about you, Derek? I want to ask you, one thing that keeps coming up throughout the three nights is that a lot of the spirits here, unlike some of the other locations we've been to, the spirits here seem quite jovial, quite jocular, quite friendly.
I've been thrilled, David, how they've been. We've not encountered one spirit that has not been, you know, so loving. This place is full of history, of love, of enjoyment, and also take into account under wartime conditions. To me, this is the pinnacle, absolute pinnacle of our investigation to date. They really responded beyond anything I could ever imagine.
And the wonderful thing is that every day has been different. Today, I have to say, wasn't expecting it at all, but what I do want to show you now is what happened tonight. Let's have a look at tonight's highlights.
Chills. I can't get it through.
Yeah, that sounded like a footstep.
Yeah. Did you hear that? Did anybody else hear it?
It's an investigation to date. Yeah. they've really responded beyond anything I could ever imagine.
And the wonderful thing is that every day has been different. Today, I have to say, wasn't expecting it at all, but what I do want to show you now is what happened tonight. Let's have a look at tonight's highlights.
Okay, I can't get it through. You hear that? That sounded like a footstep.
Yeah? Did you hear that? Did anybody else hear
it?
Yes,
it's wrong. Whoever the
You're going to do it anymore. I'm going to have to leave.
I can hear you. Flight! Flight! Did you hear that? Did you hear that? It's okay, don't be worried. Oh, my face! Whoa. Take it off! Take it off!
And would you be able to pick up? You alright?
Yes, yes, okay.
I'm burning.
The German prisoners of war here. In groups.
Yes.
From events.
Oil Did you field. Feel that?
Yes. Is it MacPherson?
Oh, oh God. MacPherson, thank you. Please, please stop spinning the table.
And I have to jump in and say to you, Yvette, final comments to you. How have you felt about tonight and indeed the whole 3 days investigation?
It makes you want to go on, do more. We will not stop until I actually see a ghost standing right there in front of me. I've got to keep going on. And of course, we've got the brand new series of Most Haunted. It's 9 o'clock, starts tomorrow. You've got to watch it. Absolutely fantastic.
Well, thank you very much to all of you guys. Thank you to all of our team. Thank you to Julian and Interactive. Thank you to our historians, Richard Jones and Richard Felix. Our experts, Louis Saver, David Wells, and of course, Brian Shepherd. Our team, Kieran O'Keefe, Derek Acora, and Yvette Fielding. And all of you here, our audience tonight, and indeed over the 3 nights, because all of you have been brilliant. Last night's audience, fabulous to brave the elements. All of you have been really, really amazing. And now we do have to take our leave from you. I can tell you, though, we will be returning for another Most Haunted Live over Halloween, where you can forget all the trick-or-treat cliches and you can investigate on what All Souls' Eve really means. It has been an amazing 3 days. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. I know all of us have. And that is it from the world's largest psychic hunt here in Canberra in Northwest Wales. From all of us here, good night.